Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon, all of you. Our next topic discussion on asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is also called vegetative propagation. So, what about asexual reproduction? Mode of asexual reproduction that is already previously discussed. So, mode of asexual reproduction, several types, that is fission, budding, sporulation, fragmentation, and vegetative propagation. In asexual reproduction, modes of asexual reproduction we are discussing. In that last heading, vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation. See, asexual reproduction in flowering plant occurs through vegetative parts of a plant. Those vegetative parts develop and gives rise to a new plant. That is called vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction. What is vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction? See here, asexual reproduction, single parent is involved. Asexual reproduction in flowering plants occurs through vegetative parts of a plant. Vegetative parts of a plant. Those vegetative parts in the plants are grown day by day and gives rise to new individuals. That process is called vegetative propagation. That is also called vegetative reproduction. See, in plants, vegetative propagation or vegetative parts of a plant, that is root, stem and leaves. These are units of vegetative propagation. These are the units of vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation occurs through these root, stem, leaves. Therefore, these are also called vegetative propagules. Vegetative propagules. Okay, so vegetative parts of a plant, root, gives rise to a new plant. Stem, it can give rise to a new plant. Leaves, it can give rise to a new plant. Therefore, these are called vegetative propagules. Reproductive parts of a plant. Reproducing parts of a plant. Okay, that's all. So these are all can give rise to new individuals. Okay, that is the definition of vegetative propagation. Okay, so asexual reproduction in flowering plants occurs through vegetative parts of a plant. Vegetative parts of a plant such as the roots, stems, leaves. Those can give rise to a new individuals and develops into new plants. This process or phenomenon is called vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction. Vegetative propagules are stem, roots, and leaves. Types of vegetative propagation. See, vegetative propagation is mainly two types. Natural methods of vegetative propagation. Natural method of vegetative propagation. Another one is artificial method of vegetative propagation. Artificial method of vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation mainly occurs through two types. One is natural method of vegetative propagation. Another one is artificial methods of vegetative propagation. Mainly in this class, I will talk about natural methods of vegetative propagation. Natural methods of vegetative propagation is again three types. That is, vegetative propagation by roots. Next, this is first one. Second one, vegetative propagation by stem. And third one, vegetative propagation by leaf. So these three are natural methods of vegetative propagation. So in these, first of all, let us give discussion about vegetative propagation by roots. See, the swollen roots of carrot, turnip and radish. Indeed, the swollen roots of carrot, turnip and radish have number of buds at their basal part. Those buds, for example, radish. So swollen root, this is a swollen bulged root. Swollen roots on carrot, turnip, radish have number of small buds. These buds if we cut and those cut part if we will keep in the soil, it will give rise to new plant. It is day by day grown into radish or carrot or turnip, like that structures. Okay, that is called vegetative propagation by root. The swollen roots of carrot, turnip, radish have number of buds. Okay, this is one. Next, swollen roots of tubers in potato. Swollen roots of tubers in potato. Okay, the swollen roots of tubers in potato asparagus, dahlia and yam produces number of adventitious buds. See, swollen roots of tubers in potato, for example, this is the tubers potato, sorry. So this potato produces swollen roots of tubers. These are called buds. Like this way, structures in asparagus, dahlia and yam, those are called adventitious buds. Those adventitious buds can give rise to new plants. That is called vegetative propagation by roots. Okay, that's all. See, it is a potato. It has a number of buds or eyes. Eyes of buds are eyes. Simply eyes are buds. Eyes of potato are buds. If we will cut this part and keep it in the soil, this particular part grow into a new individual plant. This part like that. How many plants? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These 5 buds we can call bud or eyes of potato. These parts if we will cut and keep it in the soil, sown in the soil, it will grow as a new individual and gives rise to new plants. That is called vegetative propagation by roots. Next, vegetative propagation by stems. Various modifications of underground stem. Already first piece I said. Underground stem. Subaerial stem. Various modifications of underground stem and subaerial stems serve as means of vegetative propagation. Means of vegetative propagation. What is that? Underground stem and subaerial stem. Underground stem, which absolutely grow below the ground. Subaerial stem, half part is below the ground, half part is above the ground. These two are serve as means of vegetative propagation. Now, in this class, we have to keep discussion about underground stem and subaerial stem. Then, vegetative propagation by stem topic is finished. Thereafter, vegetative propagation by leaf, we can talk. So, first of all, let us see. So there are several types of underground stem modification. The first PUC I said very thoroughly. Keeping in the view of the second PUC, I gave extraordinary information in first PUC only. What are the points we discussed there? The same points once again we will recapitulate in this topic. So underground stem. Rhizome. It is underground stem which grow horizontally below the ground. Underground stem which grow horizontally. Horizontally below the ground. Below the ground. Okay, so the rhizome which grow below the ground, it will grow certain length, certain distance. After that, the underground rhizome swollen. Underground rhizome is swollen with storage food material. Okay, storage food material. For example, here I will show one diagram. See that. like this way. Example, ginger. Ginger. Turmeric. And banana. In these plants below the ground, a rhizome with swollen food material is located. A rhizome with swollen food material is located. That is called rhizome. Next, second one is bulb. As everybody knows that bulb, it consists of very short stem. In the bulbs, it is also underground modified stem. It consists of a short stem. Like this way, vertically, short stem is located at the center. It consists of short stem. At the center of the short stem, there are number of leaves are arranged concentric circles. Number of leaves are arranged in concentric circles. Concentric circles. Number of leaves are arranged in concentric circles, which are swollen with reserved food material. Okay, that's all. So the terminal shoot is gradually developed into flower. The terminal shoot gradually developed into flower. So the lateral buds, these are all lateral buds. These lateral buds can give place to new plants. These are called bulbs. Example, onion and garlic. Onion and garlic. Onion scientific name is Allium sepa. Garlic scientific name is Allium sativum. Already first you see I said that. Okay, this is called bulbs. Third one is corms. In this one, it is also contains a short stem. Corms, it is also underground modified stem. But in this case, the stem is different. It contains a very short stem. It contains very short stem. But in this case, the stem is different. The stem which stores food material. In previous, the concentric circles called leaves. Leaves stores the food material. But in this case, the stem itself stores the food material. Okay, like this, it will store the food material. Next, like this way, it forms scales. These are called scales. So like this way, the stem stores the food material. This is called short stem stores the food material. The short stem stores the food material. So the leaves are horizontally located on stems. This is called corms. Okay, so just like above, at the tip of the shoot can give rise to flowers. So below, there are number of buds can give rise to new plants on either sides of the corms. That is called corms. Example, colocasia. Colocasia and alocasia. Colocasia and alocasia. Alocasia. It is C. Colocasia and alocasia. In these, the stem itself stores the food material. Either sides of the stem, leaves are horizontally arranged. With the horizontal lines, the leaves are arranged. Okay, that's all. This is called corms. Tubers. See, this is also underground modified stem. Tubers means example, potato. potato. It is also underground modified stem with tuberous roots. Tuberous roots. The tuberous root gradually turned to be a potato. Tuberous root gradually turned to be a potato. See, like this way. This is a tuberous root. This tuberous root gradually modified and turned to be potato. Turned to be potato. Potato. Okay, so it contains number of eyes. See, these are all nodes. Nodes. Those nodes contains small bud that is called eyes of potato. So eyes of potato, which is arisen from when this, it is called eyes of potato, also called bud. When we cut this part, then we can cut the bud, and the cut part, if you will keep it in the soil, it will grow as a new individual plant. So each potato can give rise to a number of eyes or buds, which can give rise to a new individual plant. New plants. Example, potato. Generally, potato crop can be grown by the buds. Those buds are called eyes of potato, or buds, or tuberous roots. Tuberous roots. Okay, these are called tubers. Tubers or tuberous roots. So potato crop can be grown by buds, not by seeds. Okay, it does not produce any type of a seeds. It can be grown by the buds. Okay, so if we will keep it like that only, it can produce seeds. Seeds can be produced, but we cannot cultivate potato plants, potato crop by seeds. It can be cultivated by the bud or eyes. Those eyes are formed from nodes. Nodes. These are all called node. Node. The node can give rise to bud. Even in our home also, if you store potato about 20 days or 30 days, after 1 month, each potato can give rise to 10 to 15 buds. Those buds, if you will keep it in the soil, it will be germinated and can give rise to new individuals. That is called tubers. Underground stem. Underground stem is rhizome, bulbs, cores. Tubers. Rhizome example. Already we discussed that. What is that? Ginger, turmeric, banana. Turmeric, banana. Bulbs, onion, allium sepa. Garlic, allium sativum. Corms, colocasia, alocasia. Tubers, potato. These are all the things first PUC only you studied. Okay? Those topics again, if you revise, it is good enough. Actually, in second PUC, about the vegetative propagation, they did not give much matter. Very simple vegetative propagation and a few diagrams they gave. Okay, only that teaching, it's not a good. So that I am explaining elaborately. But from these concepts, objective bits definitely will come. Immediately after finishing this chapter, I will start NEET CET objective bits. Then you will get to know that it. Okay? So don't think that more matter is teaching. It is necessary. Okay? That's why I am giving to you. Next topic. Subaerial stem. Subaerial stem means half portion is below the ground, remaining half portion is above the ground. That's why it is called subaerial stems. So the subaerial stems are several types. Those are, first one is runner. Second one is suckers. Third one is stolons. And fourth one is offsets. These four are the examples of subaerial stem. Runners, the word itself saying the significance. Runners, the plant parts are run rapidly. That's why these are called runners. Example, grass, mint, and strawberry. Strawberry, grass, mint, and strawberry. See here. See. Like that. Plant part can be grown. Okay? Plant part can be grown. See here, below the ground root will be grown. So, from the stem and root part, a small node, a small stem is run aside. A small stem is run from base part of the plant. So, like this way it will run. When this stem is comes in contact with the soil, here it will produce these roots below the ground, and above the ground stem forms. Stem forms. Like this way, stem is formed. Like this way, above the ground, stem is formed. Below the ground, roots are formed. And again, from this small bud is starts. This bud or stem gradually grow. But small bud is grown. And again, when it comes in contact with soil, it again produces roots. And above the ground, stem formed. And same way inside, below the ground and above the ground. Like that, it runs. That's why these are called runners. Okay, when the parental plant gives a small bud, this bud will grow continuously, and when it comes in contact with soil, it will give rise to a new individual. Okay, those are called runners. Next, suckers. See here. Suckers. See here, it is a parental plant here growing. Above the ground, parental plant growing. Parental plant growing. So from the below the ground, root can produce a small sucker. Small needle-like structure or small bud. So this bud, like this way, buds are formed. This bud, like this way, horizontally will grow. This bud horizontally will grow below the ground. Horizontally grow below the ground. And day by day, grown. And it emerges above the ground. Stem. This stem gradually forms leaf-like structures. And here, number of roots are formed. Then, if we will cut this part, it will grow as a new individual plant. Like this way, there are number of, this will grow. Like this, from here again. Like this way. Continuously, number of suckers are formed, number of buds are formed, These buds are called needle-like structures. These needle-like structures around the parental plant produces number of new plants. These are all the new plants emerges above the ground. Below the ground, root system. Those are called suckers. Those are called suckers. Example. Chrysanthemum indica. Chrysanthemum indica. Everybody knows that. Sevanti. Example. Sevanti. Chrysanthemum indica and pineapple. Pineapple. Chrysanthemum indica, pineapple and rasp. Raspberry. Raspberry. That is called suckers. Stolons. Stolons. In this one also same. In this also same. See. When the parental plant is growing like this way. Parental plant is growing like this way. When the small bud or branch, when the small bud or branch comes in contact with soil, comes in contact with soil. From the parental plant, when small bud or stem comes in contact with soil, it will give rise to a new plant. Below the ground, number of roots are formed. It forms like this arch. Arch. So above the ground, leaves are formed. If we will cut it, it will grow as a new individual plant. These are called stolons. Example, jasmine. Blackberry, blackberry, jasmine, etc. Next, last and final, offset. 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 See here, these are one internode long runner plant. See, it is a node. Water. It is node. Below the ground, adventitious roots are formed. Number of adventitious roots are formed. Above the ground, like this way, tuft of leaves. A cluster of leaves. Hair-like leaves above the ground. Below the ground, adventitious roots. Below the water, above the water. Actually, these are aquatic plants. Above the water, tuft of leaves. Below the water, adventitious roots are formed. So from this node, one internode run aside. In these plants, one internode, long runner plant. One internode, this is called internode, runs. Runs like this way. From here, one more node is formed. Above the node, like this way, leaves are formed. Below the ground, number of roots are formed. This is called offset. These are, in these, one internode long runner plants. Below the ground, adventitious roots. Above the water, below the water, adventitious. Above the water, upper surface of water, like this way, leaves are spread. So like this way, it is continuously spread. There is no stop. Throughout pond and rivers, like this way, plants are spread. These plants are called Icornia. Example, Icornia. Water hyacinth. Icornia. It is also called water hyacinth. And one more, pistia. Pistia. Pistia plant also, like we say, spread in the rivers and ponds. Okay, pistia, water cabbage. Pistia also called water cabbage. Icornia is also called water hyacinth. Okay, so these two are underground stem modifications and subaerial stem modifications. Okay, underground stems and subaerial stems serve as means of vegetative propagation.